Hey guys, it's Mr. Walker here, and welcome to another math lesson with Mr. Walker. Today we're getting into some new territory, some familiar stuff, but also some new stuff. We're going to begin to dive into how to multiply and divide fractions, okay? But before we get into all that kind of stuff, we're going to take a look at fractions and kind of compare fractions using benchmarks like we've done in the past. And we're also going to be taking a look at how we can look at fractions and how they can relate to like length, and how we can actually plot those different lengths on something called a line plot. And a line plot is just a way to kind of like chart some data, and it kind of looks like a bar graph, but with like x's. We'll take a look at that, what that looks like in a second. But it's just kind of like a starter thing to get us thinking about fractions and how they can relate and what they have in common and things like that. So all you're really going to need for today is something to write on, something to write with. You are going to need this sheet, like the pencil length activity sheet. It's available in your module. You can print it out. And if you want, like, I'm going to cut mine out and glue it down to some construction paper just to make it look kind of cool. So if you have a sheet of construction paper and you want to do that, you may, but you don't necessarily have to. Okay, so make sure you have those things gathered up. You're ready to go. And then go ahead and click continue and we'll keep rolling. Alright, so I have my pencil lengths activity sheet here ready to go. We're going to walk through this together, and you'll notice it has a couple parts to it. So this first part is where we're actually going to draw our line plot, okay? And I'm going to show you what that looks like in a second, how we do that. Then we have some questions we're going to answer, and over here we have some data, right? We have all these pencils, we have 10 pencils, and the length of these pencils. And we're actually going to be taking these lengths, labeling them on our line plot, and then plotting how many we have of each length, okay? So I'm going to go ahead and cut this out. You can see that there's like dotted lines going all the way around here. I'm going to cut this out, I'm going to glue this down, and then I'm going to glue these questions down. I'm going to show you what that looks like. Again, you can follow along and do this with me on a piece of construction paper. It's just kind of fun to get some different types of modality in there and kind of move things around. It's not necessarily required, though, if you don't feel like doing it, but play along with me and have some fun, okay? So let me go ahead and get this set up, and then we'll keep going. Alright, I got my two pieces cut out here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to glue this whole thing down. But on this sheet, I'm just going to glue this like little strip right here. These are like our questions. So if I put like a little bead of glue here, right? What's more fun than watching your teacher glue down some paper? Pretty good stuff, right? So I'm going to go ahead and flip this over here. Glue it down like that. So eventually, when it dries, I'll be able to like flip these up and answer the questions underneath. And I could actually cut out along that line too if I wanted to, but you kind of get the idea. Okay, so I got my line graph started glued down here, and I got my questions underneath here. Okay, make sure you have that, or at least you have that sheet ready to go, and that you have your pencil lengths as well, because those are going to come in handy. All right, once you got that and you're good to go, click continue and we'll keep on rolling. All right, guys, so what we have here is some data, and we have the start to a line plot here. All right. And we have to put these different lengths of these 10 different pencils onto this line plot. So the first thing we need to do is figure out, like, what are we going to put along this number line? Because that's essentially what a line plot is. We use a number line, and up here we kind of chart how many of each length we have, how many of each number we have going along that number line. So we have to figure out, like, what numbers do we need to put down here in order to graph this data, okay? Well, if I look at the data, all right, if I look a little closer here, so we could see, we have all of these numbers going along the side here, and it looks like I have 8. And these numbers are actually like over 8, right? 8 1/4, 8 1/2. Zoom this in a little bit so you guys can see a little better. Fancy zoom techniques, right? It's called moving the document camera. All right, so we got all these lengths down here. So we have like 8 1/4, 8 1/2, 7 3/4, 7 1/2, things like that. So I don't see any whole numbers bigger than 9, because these are all bigger than 8, right? Because they go over 8, 8 1/4, 8 1/3, 8 1/2, 8 1/4. They're all greater than 8, but nothing over 9. And I don't see anything less than 7. Okay, so those I think should be our 2 points, right? We have 7, that's as small as we need to go, and 9, we're not going to need to go any bigger than 9. So everything else is going to fall somewhere in between on that line, okay? So I'm going to zoom this back out so we can see the whole page. Fancy zooming techniques, okay? So I'm going to move this over here now, and on my line plot here, like I said, I'm going to start with 7. Okay, 7's going to fall at my end. And then on my other side, I'm going to say 9, right? Nothing's greater than 9. So 9 can be like my stopping point on this side of things. So 7 and 9. So in between 7 and 9, what number is going to come in between 7 and 9? 8, right? So 8's going to be my middle point. All right, awesome. So I'm putting some points in here now. If I go back, if I look at this data for a second, well, I have fourths, I have halves, I have eighths, fourths, halves, eighths. So I need to figure out my halves. And from there, I figure out the fourths. From there, I can figure out the eighths. And those are all the points that I'm going to have to put on my line plot. So nothing terrible here. Those all kind of have something in common, so they're pretty easy to do. So where would the halves be on this line plot? Go ahead and draw yours in and compare them to mine, and let's see what we get. Well, half between 7 and 8 would be 7 and a half, and that guy's going to fall right here in the middle, right? 7 and a half, so I'm just going to label that as 1 half. Same thing here, in between my 8 and my 9, that's going to be another half. All right, so now that I have my halves drawn in here, I could draw my quarters. So I already split it into two pieces. Now I want to split in between each number to four pieces, okay? So if I split this guy here, this would be 1/4. This guy would actually be 2/4, right? Same thing, 1/2 and 2/4, same number. And then this would be 3/4. Okay? And again, this would be 1/4, 2/4. This guy would be 3/4. Cool? All right, good so far. Let's go ahead. We know we're going to have eighths in there too, so let's draw those eighths in there. Again, if we're just kind of split in between those fourths, we're going to go even further. Because if we look at this now, if we're talking about fourths, like four pieces from each whole number, 1, 2, 3, 4. There's fourths right there, 1, 2, 3, 4. Each one of these pieces here is a fourth. So if I do this again, so this is going to be 1/8. This would be the same as 2/8. This would be 3/8. 1/2, 2/4, and 4/8. I'm going to have to write that kind of tiny down here. 4/8, you get the idea. 5/8. 6/8. 7/8. And then 8/8, that would be a whole, okay? Same thing over here. This would be 1/8, 2/8, 3/8, 4/8, 5/8, 6/8, and 7/8. Okay, so now we have these different points, these different measurements along here. These are all in inches, so we have 7 inches, 8 inches, 9 inches, and all these spots in between. And we need that because we have all these measurements down here that we need to plot on our line plot, okay? So hopefully that's starting to make sense. Make sure that yours are labeled as well, that you have the same measurements down there. And let's get this in focus for you. Cool, so go ahead and label yours up as well. Once you have that, click continue and we'll keep going. All right, guys, awesome. So now I'm actually gonna start plotting these different pencil lengths that I have onto my line plot. Okay, so let's look at pencil number 1 here. Pencil number 1 measures in inches, length in inches, is 8 1/4. So if I come over here, I'm going to go to 8 1/4, okay? So that's what that pencil is going to measure, 8 1/4. So I'm going to put an X right over that measurement because I have one pencil that measures 8 1/4, okay? Which is where this measurement is, 8 1/4. Cool. So 1 is taken care of. Let's go to number 2. Number 2 here says 8 1/2. So 8 1/2 is right here, so I'm going to put an X here for 8 1/2. So far, we're just putting an X for every pencil length that we have. Let's go to the next one here. We did number 1, number 2, number 3, 7 3/4, 7 3/4. So if I go to 7, and let's see where my 3/4 felt, right there, right? 1, 2, 3/4. I'm going to put an X there. Cool. Doing good so far. 7 1/2. So 7 1/2. 7 1/2 is going to fall right there. Cool. So far, so good. all those different measurements that we hit so far, they all have one X. They all have one pencil that measures that. Let's go down here to 8 3/8. 8 3/8. Cool. Put an X there for that. And 7 7/8. Awesome. 7 7/8. There. Now I have 8 1/4. 8 1/4. Oh, wait a second. I already have an X there. It's because I already had a pencil that measured that. Now I have another pencil that measures that. And that's okay, because this is the data that we have. This is the data that we collected. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put another X right above that X, okay? So just imagine we have these pencils and like we're grouping them by the sizes that they are, right? So I would put all the pencils that measure 1 1/4 in this pile right here. That's why I'm putting those X's on top of each other. I'm stacking them up because that's what those pencils measure. So far, every other measurement that we've measured only has one pencil that measures that. 8 1/4, that's 2. All right, so there's only 3 more measurements on here. I'm going to let you guys finish your line plot up, draw out, put those X's on there for those measurements, and then meet me back here, and we'll compare what we have. All right, awesome. So this is the way my line plot came out, and it looks to me like the pencil that has the most measurements is 8 1/4. 8 1/4 has 3 pencils that measure 8 1/4. These other two, 7 3/4 and 8 1/2, they both have 2 pencils, and then these guys all have 1. Okay, pretty cool. So we could see a lot easier now, like where these pencils group out. We can kind of lay that data out. This is perfect for like a STEM fair project or something where you do an experiment and you want to kind of show off the data that you gathered. Line plots work great for that. They're actually even easy to turn into like a bar graph because, you know, you make squares around them and stuff like that. You know, one graph kind of leads into another. So this is cool that we can graph data this way. So let's look at some questions that we have down here and see if we can answer these questions. First of all, if we just came up with some like off the top of our head questions, which pencil length had the most pencils that measured that? Well, that would be our 8 1/4, right? Most pencils measured that. There's a tie for the ones that measured the fewest, and that would be our 7 1/2, our 7 7/8, and our 8 3/8. Those have the least amount of pencils that measured that, okay? So hopefully the part of like taking the data and putting it on the line plot, hopefully that's making some sense to you. So let's look at some of these questions then. This one says, if you took all the pencils that are shorter than 8 inches and lined them up end to end, what would the total length be? So we're talking any pencil that's shorter than 8 inches. So anything on this side of the 8-inch mark. If we took those and lined them up end to end, what would the total length be? Well, if we put them end to end, right, we're adding them up. So basically, we would be doing this. Let me go ahead and cut this real quick. Easy. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and cut this. I'm going to fold this over so I can actually like write my thoughts in here. So I would have 1/2 pencil that measured 1/2, 7 1/2, I should say, 7 1/2. I would have 7 3/4, and I would have another 7 3/4, right, because I have 2 pencils there. And then I would have a 7 7/8. Cool, so I would have those measurements, and if I added them up, if I line them up, put them all together, what would the length of them be? What would the total of that be? So I can add these fractions together, and right now I can look and say, okay, here's a fourth, right? These two have fourths, so can I change these other guys to fourths? Well, 1/2 I can change to 2/4, so I can say this is 7 2/4, that's the same amount, right? Plus 7 3/4, plus 7 3/4, plus 7 8, can I change that to fourths? Let's see, well, if this is 3/4, can I get that back to, not really, okay? So let me add these fourths up first, and then I'll see if I can add on that eighth. So 7 2/4 plus 3/4 is 5/4, 6/4, 7/4, 8/4. So 7 8/4, which obviously is gonna be greater than a whole right here. So let's see, how many fourths are there in 8? So basically what I'm thinking here is, we're talking fourths, right? I have 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8/4. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8/4. 8/4 is the same as 2 whole. So really, 7 8/4 is equal to 9. So if this is 2 whole, 7 plus 2 more is 9. So I have 9 plus, took care of this guy, this guy, this guy. We just have 7 7/8 left. 9 plus 7 7/8 would be, well, what's 9 plus 7 is 16. 16 7/8. That would be the total length of all of those pencils. Cool. Easy enough, right? If you lined up all 10 pencils end to end, what would the total length be? Holy cow, that's a lot of things to add up. So we have to add up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All 10 of those pencils, all those different measurements, and figure out what they would be. Well, I did one example for you. If you guys want to try out that second example and shoot me an email or a text or something that tells me what you think that answer would be, I'll give you some bonus points for that. Maybe we'll enter you for some sort of prize drawing or something like that. But as long as you got the line plot down and you can make some comparisons based on your data, that's what we're kind of looking for in this lesson. So if you feel confident with that, you're going to practice it in some other practice opportunities within the module, please reach out to me if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, like always. And I appreciate you guys for watching, and I'm excited to see what you guys do. All right, thanks.